with Alan Meyerson.
And Monty Meyerson.
And we're at Remote Control, doing a little mixing. Can I tell them it's Batman?
You can tell them it's Dark Knight.
So, you gave us some great interview for a press release about your use of Antelope products. Can you just tell me what they've meant to you and your and the work that you do?
Well, the initial reason I got my first Antelope product was when I had my studio at home, I was having a lot of clocking issues in terms of just making everything work and be solid. And it was suggested to me that I try an Antelope. And the minute I put it in, everything just started working. And then as a plus, everything sounded better. You know, it just, all of my, whatever my ear defines as jitter and imaging issues sort of just came together and was instantly better. And I immediately told all my friends about it, and pretty much everyone I know immediately got an Antelope. So then I had that in my system. And then when I built this room, I took it up to another level professionally, where I was not only doing my own personal projects, but I was doing, you know, outside projects and larger projects for outside clients and just more grand things. And it became necessary for me to be able to run multiple sample rates. And I couldn't do it in the system I had set up. So it was suggested that I put in the Trinity, and I did that. And I'm rocking now. I'm actually at the moment running 96K, 48K, and 44.1 all at the same time.
So how does this relate to the final product? What do you hear that comes through in the theater for viewers?
Well, I mean, it relates to the final product many ways. One, just the quality of the clock is incredibly solid and a much superior clock. So when you have solid clocking, it's pretty much, imagine if you had two images, for those of you who know this, I'm sure you know this, if you had two images and you're overlaying them, and they're slightly offset, when you have clocking that isn't up to par, it's very hard for them to catch up and get totally in sync. And those are the words, the digital words. Well, with the Antelope, I found that image, it was like laying two images perfectly over one another, so that when you look at it, you'd see a perfect clarity. The edging is dead. And if you imagine the visual as an auditory experience, it's literally that, where the edging becomes perfect, the imaging, the left and right, the spatial dimension becomes more perfect, because you're not actually having things interacting with each other that aren't perfectly in sync. It's basically synchronizes everything audio-wise. And so that makes a huge difference in terms of film or any kind of music production, or actually any kind of audio production. And then the reason it makes a difference in my world also is the fact that it's such an advanced clock. It gives you options that you don't have with other clocks, which is, again, running multiple sample rates, which is being able to have more things than one going on at the same time.
You describe the audio in such a visual, in such visual terms.
Right.
And you think that you know, relates even more so with a large picture in a large theater.
Most definitely. And especially, and not only that, with orchestral recordings, where you're dealing with really multiple microphones and multiple tracks, where there's plenty of room for error, things coming from different rigs. That's the thing. You know, I'm running four or five Pro Tools rigs at the same time. So imagine if you have something on one rig and then something similar to it on another rig, and they're running almost perfectly in sync, to the point where you really wouldn't hear a difference. But then imagine taking those two things and just absolutely deadlining them up. And all of a sudden, you know, if you imagine like two snare drums hitting almost at the same time, and you get that kind of flam that happens, it's still a good sound. But the minute you get those transients to hit exactly right, it becomes so much better. And that's what good clocking is. That's the difference between a good clock and an average clock. And that's why I personally believe that clocking is way more important than sample rate. It's way more important than converters, because if you have a good converter with a perfect clock, you're going to have a much better sound than a perfect converter with a good clock.
So everyone's going to ask this, so I'm kind of asking this question again in a way. Does the audience benefit?
I think the audience benefits from everything that happens to them subconsciously and consciously. So that when something, when a performance is able to translate itself as a more powerful performance, that the audience relates to that. They might not be hearing, oh, wow, listen to how great that percussion sounds on the left and that cello sounds on the right, or in a rock record, listen to how clear that vocal is in the center or whatever. They might not be relating to it like that, but what it does is it increases the emotional impact, because there's just a quality to the clarity that you don't get when you have something that's not really quite as perfectly in synchronous.
Thank you very much, Alan.
My pleasure.